Nick here from Tabletop Duo, and today you will learn how to play Saboteur. Setup. Separate the cards into Action, Nugget, Start Plus Goal, and Dwarf cards. Select the number of Saboteur and Gold Miner cards according to the number of players displayed on screen. Shuffle and deal one Dwarf card to each player, who secretly looks at it and put it face down in front of them. Place the start card on the table, then shuffle the three goal cards and place them face down as indicated. The start card and the goal cards must be within 7 cards of space between them, and the goal cards need to be 1 card away from each other. Place the action cards face down next to the goal cards and deal a number of cards according to the number of players as indicated in the video. Shuffle the gold nugget cards and place them face down near the action cards deck. And now you're ready to learn how to play. Your goal is to become the player with the most nuggets at the end of 3 rounds, either by finding gold nuggets as a gold miner or preventing players from reaching the gold as a saboteur. The youngest player goes first. On your turn, you must play one card. You can play a path card, use an action card, or discard. Path cards are used to build a path from the start card to the goal cards. The card needs to be connected to a path card already on the table and fit with the other cards already into play, and form an uninterrupted connection to the start card. Gold miners should build a path to one of the goal cards, while saboteurs try to prevent that. However, be careful to not be too obvious, or people will know you are a saboteur. Note that you cannot place cards sideways, like this. Action cards hinder or help other players, remove cards from the path, or allow players to look secretly at the goal cards. Play them face up, in front of yourself or another player. The broken tool card prevents a player from playing path cards. The player must keep it next to them while the card is still valid. If you got a broken tool card, you can still play action cards or discard during your turn. A gold miner may use it on a suspicious saboteur, or the saboteur may use it to block a player from placing paths. Fixed tool cards neutralize broken tools. The fixed tool card needs to match the broken tool type. Place both cards in the discard pile. The Rockfall card allows the player affected by it to take one path card of their choice out of the maze. That card cannot be the start or goal cards. A saboteur can use this card to interrupt a path, or a gold miner can use it to remove a dead end. And the map card allows the target player to secretly look at one of the goal cards. That card is discarded afterwards. The last option to play a card is by discarding it, placing it face down on the discard pile. After playing a card, the player must draw a card from the deck. Then, play passes to the next player to the left. Whenever the deck is used up, players cannot draw cards anymore. When a path card touches a goal card and it creates an uninterrupted path from start to finish, they must turn that goal card over. If the goal card is a stone, the round continues. The revealed goal card remains face up. If the goal card has a treasure in it, the round is over. A round also ends when the draw deck runs out of cards and no player has any playable cards left in hand. When the round ends, all players reveal their dwarf cards. If the treasure was found, the player that found it draws a number of gold nuggets equal to the number of gold miners. If that player is a gold miner, they choose one card in secret, then pass the remaining cards to the next gold miner on their right, until all the cards have been dealt. Skip any saboteurs. The saboteurs win the round if the goal card with the treasure wasn't reached. In that case, give the following amount of gold nuggets according to the number of saboteurs in play. After the gold nuggets have been handed out, it's time for the next round. Repeat the setup process. The game ends after 3 rounds. The player with the most gold nuggets wins the game. If there is a tie, they share the win. And that's how you play Saboteur. I hope you liked the video. If so, hit the like button and subscribe to receive our latest how to play video updates. See you next time!